Hello and welcome to Tech and Tesla Sweden. Today, it's all about winter driving and winter safety. And I have five tips for you when it comes to driving your Tesla during winter time, when it's cold, to maximize your efficiency and also your security. It's a dirt car, and this is how it gets very quickly here in Sweden when the snow falls, and it doesn't get too cold. When it's around like -1 or 0 degrees Celsius, the car gets really dirty really quick. And for you guys that doesn't have any parking sensors as I have, it's very or extra important to keep the camera or the cameras clean. So that's my first tip: keep your cameras clean. And I have a solution for that that's very neat and easy to solve. So I always bring a spray bottle with soft soap on it. So a spray bottle with soft soap and water. I always keep it in my boot. If it's too cold, you can mix this with washer fluid instead, so it doesn't freeze. So then the only thing I do is spraying the camera with this soap solution. With this, you don't scratch the lens of the camera, because you shouldn't use your finger or a glove or something to just clean it, because there is dirt on it and that will scratch the camera, and you quickly will notice that that scratches on your screen. So as you see, this is how it looks. The side view cameras actually manages the dirt much better. They are more protected. The rear view camera is in a really bad shape. So I just spray a couple of times on the camera directly, 5, 6, 7, 8 times. And hopefully get a better view on the camera. And as you see, it clears up very quickly without scratching the lens. So always bring a spray bottle with water and soap, or water and washer fluid. Always preheat your car. So if you have the possibility to have your car connected to a socket, always preheat before traveling and doing long trips. It will increase the range massively. So to my next tip, use seat heating and steering wheel heating when the car is cold, and lower the temperature in the cabin to save energy. I'm like running it on 17 or 18 degrees in the beginning and activating the auto heater or lowering it manually to feel more warm, and also using the steering wheel heating. Overheating the cabin or having a too high temperature will consume a lot more energy than using the seat heating. So use seat heating, steering wheel heating, and lower the inside temperature when heating the car up. It will also save you a lot of energy and increase your range. The next tip is to always check your tire pressure. As you probably know, the tire pressure when you switch to the winter tires is one thing, and the tire pressure when the weather gets colder is another thing. Cold air takes less space, and that equals to lower pressure, tire pressure, in your tires. So when the weather actually drops in temperature below zero, the tire pressure will get less, and so you need to check it. Your car will warn you about it. So for instance, when I switched the tires a couple of weeks ago, I had 42 psi. Now it's down to 40 and 39, and actually I got a warning this morning when it was below -5 degrees, because the pressure temperature went down to 37. So to be able to drive safely and to save some energy, the tire pressure is important. So check your tire pressure more often and make sure that you have the right pressure when it's cold outside. To my next tip, use chill mode when driving. So if you have a performance version of your Tesla, use chill mode. You will drive, you will feel safer. You will also consume less energy because you will probably drive more steady. And that's available in pedals and steering. So we switch it from sport to chill. Then you both save energy and drive safer during winter time. It's not as fun, it's safe. So with these few tips, I'm actually able to drive almost as long as during summertime. Yesterday I took a long trip and drove 240 kilometers almost, consumed 42 kilowatt hours of energy, and had an average consumption of 177 watt hours per kilometer. That's a good consumption during winter time, and it was minus 8 and or 9 degrees Celsius. So it's cold weather, but still good consumption and good range. So follow these tips to increase your range and also your safety on the snowy roads. So what do you do to save energy during wintertime driving? Please let me know in the comments and let's have a discussion about it. Thank you for watching. Speak to you soon.